हेलो चिल्ड्रेन, हाउ आर यू ऑल चिल्ड्रेन। टुडेज सब्जेक्ट इज इंग्लिश। फर्स्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टेल मी विच पिक्चर इज दिस। इट इज अ हेन। इट इज अ हेन। हेन इज अ बर्ड। इट लेज एग्स। ऑल ऑफ यू नो दिस। देन द बेबी ऑफ अ हेन इज कॉल्ड अ चिक। CHICK, चिक। एंड हियर यू कैन सी मेनी चिक्स। CHICKS, चिक्स, मेनी चिक्स। देन द होम ऑफ अ हेन इज कॉल्ड कॉटेज। COTTAGE, cottage. The home of a hen is called cottage. You can see the picture of a cottage. The children, today I am going to teach you a new lesson, and the title of the lesson is The Little Red Hen. Title of the lesson is The Little Red Hen. Now first, let us learn new words from this lesson. I will repeat each word 3 times, and you can also repeat with me. Now first word, worked, 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 worked. Worked, worked. Number 2, planted, planted. Planted, planted. Planted, planted. Now to plant means we plant or put seeds in the ground so that it can grow. Okay, so we plant or put seeds in the ground so that it can grow. Now, number 3, changed, changed. Changed, changed. Changed, changed. Number 4, ground, ground, ground. Ground, 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 ground. Now here in this lesson, ground means made into a powder, made into a powder. Now number 5, helped, 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 helped. Helped, helped. Number 6, dance, 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 dance. Number 7, growing, 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 growing. Growing, growing. Number 8, sprouts, 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 sprouts. Now children, sprout means shoot of a plant, shoot, shoot of a plant. Now I will show you the picture of a shoot of a plant after the new words. Okay, so let's go to the number 9, beautiful, 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 beautiful. Number 10, tiny, tiny, tiny means small, you all know. tiny, 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 tiny. Number 11, summer, 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 summer is a season. Then number 12, grains, 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 grains. All of you know grains of wheat, grains of rice. Yes. Now number 13, loaf, 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 loaf. Now loaf is a bread. Generally we say loaf of a bread. So loaf is a bread baked in one piece and sliced before it is eaten. So you have to always remember loaf of a bread. Number 14, picked, 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 picked. Then number 15, flour, 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 flour. Now children, as I told you, I will show you the picture of a shoot of a plant. Here you can see the picture of a shoot of a plant, which is also called as sprouts. So when we put or plant seed under the ground or in the ground, then the plant starts growing. So initially it is called as a shoot of a plant when it comes out of the ground. Okay, so this is a shoot of a plant, or you can say sprouts. Now make sentences. Now the first given word is tiny, tiny. The ant is a tiny animal. The ant is a tiny animal. Number 2, happy, happy, happy. Now let's make the sentence from the given word happy. I was happy to see my grandmother after a long time. Okay, I was happy to see my grandmother after a long time. Number 3, beautiful. The peacock is a beautiful bird. The peacock is a beautiful bird. Okay, children. Children, this is your lesson, The Little Red Hen. Now, before I read this lesson, let me explain it to you briefly. Once there lived a little red hen with her chicks. She had three friends, the lamb, the goose and the cat. One day the little red hen was out walking with her friends and she found a few grains of wheat. So she asked her friends, who will help me plant these grains of wheat? The lamb said, not I. The goose said, not I. The cat said, not I. In this way, her friends refused to help her as they were very lazy. Then the little red hen said, "Okay, I will plant these grains in the ground." And she did just that. Then what happened, children? After few days, she saw sprouts or shoots coming out of the ground. Means the wheat grains she had planted were growing. They grew and grew throughout the summer season. Then she again asked her friends, "Who will help me pick up the wheat grains?" Then again the lamb said, "Not I." The goose said, "Not I." The cat said, "Not I." In this way, again her friends refused to help her to pick up the wheat. So the little red hen said, "Okay, I will pick up the wheat." And she did just that. Next morning, she again asked her friends, "Now who will help me to take these wheat grains to the mill to grind it into wheat flour?" But children, again her friends refused to help her. The lamb said, "Not I." The goose said, "Not I." The cat said, "Not I." Then the little red hen said, "Okay, I will take these wheat grains to the mill to grind it into wheat flour." And she did just that. Then next morning, the little red hen baked a beautiful loaf from the wheat flour. And then again she asked her friends, "Who will help me eat the beautiful loaf of bread?" Then what happened, children? The lamb said, "I will." The goose said, "Yummy, I will." The cat said, "Oh, it's looking really beautiful. I will eat this beautiful loaf of bread." So now her friends get agreed, or they were agreed to eat the loaf of bread. But now the little red hen said, "No, you will not eat this beautiful bread because you didn't help me. You always refused to help me. You did not want to work. So I am going to eat this bread with my cheeks." And the little red hen did just that. So children, now tell me, what do you understand from this story? We should help our friends. Whenever your friend asks you for help, you should help your friend. Always remember, a friend in need is friend indeed. So the moral of the story is, we should always help each other. Okay, now let me read this lesson. Title of the lesson is The Little Red Hen. Once upon a time, there lived a little red hen and her small chicks. They all lived in a tiny cottage. The chicks looked like soft golden balls. So, how did the chicks look like? The chicks look like soft golden balls. The little red hen worked very hard to feed her little chicks. Means the little red hen was hard working. She liked to sing and dance as she worked. One day, the little red hen was out walking with her friends, the lamb, the goose, and the cat. While they were walking and talking, she found a few grains of wheat. "Who will help me plant these grains?" she asked. "Not I," said the lamb. "Not I," said the goose. "Not I," said the cat. The little red hen looked at the grains of wheat. Then she looked at her friends. "Very well, I shall plant these myself," she said, and she did just that. Early one morning, the little red hen went out to see where she had planted the wheat. She saw tiny green sprouts coming out of the ground. She was very happy. The wheat she had planted was growing. "Hurry, come and look at the wheat," she cried to her chicks. The wheat grew and grew all summer. It slowly changed from green to golden yellow. "Who will help me pick the wheat?" asked the little red hen. "Not I," said the lamb. "Not I," said the goose. "Not I," said the cat. The little red hen looked at the grains of wheat. Then she looked at her friends. "Very well, I shall pick the wheat myself," she said, and she did just that. She picked all the wheat and put it in a sack. Now it was ready to go to the flour mill to be made into fine flour. Early next morning, the little red hen said, "Who will help me take the wheat to the mill and have it ground into flour?" "Not I," said the lamb. "Not I," said the goose. "Not I," said the cat. The little red hen looked at the sack of grain. Then she looked at the lamb, the goose, and the cat. "Then I will take the wheat myself," she said, and she did. The next day, the little red hen baked a beautiful loaf of bread. She asked the lamb, the goose, and the cat, "Who will help me eat this beautiful loaf of bread?" "I will," said the lamb. "I will," said the goose. "I will," said the cat. "No, you won't," said the little red hen. "None of you help me. You did not want to work," she said. "I am going to eat the bread with my chicks," said the little red hen, and she did. So children, I hope you understood this lesson very well. Now let's see the answer the following questions. Okay, now question number 1. What did the little red hen do when she found the grains of wheat? Answer: upon finding the grains of wheat, The little red hen asked her friends for help in planting them. When they refused, she planted the grains herself. Okay. Question number 2. Did the lamb, the goose, and the cat do a wise thing by not helping the little red hen? Answer: No. The lamb, the goose, and the cat did not do a wise thing by not helping the little red hen. Question number 3. What do you think would have happened if they had helped her? Actually, they were the lamb, the cat, the goose. They were little red hen's friends. So they should have helped her, but they refused to help her. So what do you think would have happened if they had helped her? Answer: If they had helped the little red hen, they would have got a chance to eat a beautiful loaf of bread with her. Now question number 4. What stages did the grains go through to become a loaf of bread? What stages did the grains go through to become a loaf of bread? Answer: First, the grains were planted. Soon they started sprouting green leaves. They grew all summer and changed from green to golden yellow color. When they became ripe, they were picked up and made into flour in a flour mill. The flour was finally baked into a loaf of bread. So what are the stages, children? First, the grains were planted. Then they started sprouting green leaves. Then they grew and grew throughout the summer season and changed from green to golden yellow color. Now here, changing the color from green to golden yellow shows they became ripe. Then they were picked and made into wheat flour. And finally, the flour was baked into a loaf of bread. Okay, children? Now, question number 5. Should we help others? Why? Yes, we should help others. Because if we help someone in need, we too will receive help from someone. So children, here you have to always remember, if we help others, then we will also get help from them. So we should always help each other. Now it's activity time. Draw or stick your favorite animal on a piece of paper. Stick spices and grains of different colors to make it colorful. So children, here in this activity, you have to draw or stick your favorite animal on a piece of paper, and then you have to stick spices and grains on it. Now let me show you how it will look. See, like this, you can draw or stick any picture of animal or bird, and then you can stick colorful grains or spices on it. See one more example. Yes. Okay. Now, Home assignment. Learn the new words and do the practice of reading the lesson. Okay, children? So, bye-bye.